Hey everyone, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video. Last week I captured a beautiful sunrise image on which I want to work today. And since there's a lot of contrast going on with bright highlights and super dark shadows, I'm creating an HDR image inside of Lightroom and I will finish the post-processing with Photoshop. So before I start the editing, let's first check out the before and after images. Alright, and as I just said, this image is a little bit problematic since we have bright highlights and dark shadows. To fix that, I recorded a bracketed shot. That means I have this dark photo, which I will be using for the highlights, and the super bright photos, which will help restore the shadows. And then we have also this kind of middle ground image. And now to create the HDR image, I'm simply selecting the three bracketed shots, right click on them and go to Photo Merge HDR. Lightroom will then generate a preview image like this. You could use the auto settings, but I'd like to do it manually so I have more control over the editing. Once you have chosen your settings, just hit the merge button. And after the merging, you will end up with an HDR file. You can see I have already cropped it a little bit. So then let's start by activating the lens correction as usual. For the camera profile, this time I'm going with Adobe Vivid, since this will give the image really, really great color tones. Also, I'm not changing the white balance, since I like the overall look of it. But now let's make use of the higher dynamic range, because we have merged the HDR image. First, I want to make everything a little bit brighter, so let's just increase the exposure slightly. Then let's drop the highlights a little bit. And now increase the shadows all the way up. And you can see we get this nice detail in the darker areas already. Then let's add some vibrance. Just because I like this image to be super colorful and saturated. And then let's also add a little bit of texture. Okay, now I feel like the image could be a bit brighter. So I have created a gradiated filter. And you can see this filter goes over the whole image. But for this gradiated filter, I don't want it to affect the brightest highlights. And we can simply do that by creating a luminance range mask. And that's super useful since it allows us to set a range for the luminance we want to work on. And since I don't want the highlights to be affected, I simply drop the range down. And in this case, everything that's red will be affected by this filter. Okay, now I want the darker areas to be a little bit brighter, so let's just increase the whites. Now without the luminance mask, the picture would get easily overexposed by increasing the whites. I have also created two radial filters, which I want to use to add a little bit of glow on the horizon. And I simply do this by increasing the blacks and then do this on the second radial filter. And that's it for the local adjustments already. Then of course there's some color grading going on. I further want to boost those sunrise colors, so I'm increasing the red saturation. And let's also increase the purple saturation. Okay, cool. Then I also want to do some split toning. And this time I'm going more into the purple color region for the highlights. And then let's increase the strength. Nice. Now I could apply a cold color tone to the shadows, but for this image, I think it looks quite good this way. All right, then let's sharpen this picture real quick. Okay, and now we can finish the editing in Photoshop. Alright, and first I want to get rid of a few things here. So let's first remove that car with the spot healing brush. And then let's also remove that other stuff. Okay, next I might want to apply a little bit of glow. So let's create a new layer right here. And then change the blending mode to hard light. Then I'm grabbing the brush tool and by holding down the Alt key and clicking in this area, I'm selecting a color from there Now with the brushed opacity around 10%, I'm carefully painting in some glow. And of course, I also want to do this on the right side. Maybe let's drop the opacity of that glow a bit. Okay. Then I want to merge those two layers by selecting them and hitting Ctrl E. And I want to apply some final effects by going through the Nick collection. Now I could make this a little bit more colorful by using the skylight filter, which will simply boost those sunrise colors. Here you just need to be careful since that's easily overdone. Okay, I think that looks good. I still want to mask out a few areas, so I'm creating a layer mask by hitting this little icon right there. And now I'm inverting the mask, and now you can see the effect is not visible anymore, but now I can use a white brush to paint back in some of this effect on certain areas. So if I paint over those clouds, they will get a little bit more saturated, and I can do this on the left side as well. And also on the foreground, I guess. And as this effect is super strong right now, I want to further drop the opacity. And I think that's much, much better. So then let's again check the Nick collection. And finally, I want to add the classical soft focus just to add this dreamy look to the image. And I'm going with the first soft focus method. Okay. Again, I don't want to have this effect over the whole image. So let's create another layer mask on this layer. And again, invert it so I can paint in this glow myself by simply using a white brush. And on the left side, I want this glow to be over the horizon. And on the right side, I think I want to do the same thing, but with a bit of a reduced opacity. Let's turn it down on the left side, actually. Okay, that's much better. And now before I start to overdo the editing, let's stop at this point. So I hope this video was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions regarding the editing, then please let me know in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.